Hello friends, today's tutorial shows how to create and customize PDF portfolios in Adobe Acrobat using the updated interface on PC and Mac. We'll also look at the best way to add web content to PDF portfolios. If you're using an older version of Adobe Acrobat, please see my previous tutorial on the same topic, which will be linked below. Before we start, let's quickly answer the question, what is a PDF portfolio? A PDF portfolio is essentially a container that groups multiple files under one file name. Each file added to the portfolio maintains its original file type, such as a JPEG image, Microsoft Word document, or Excel spreadsheet. The files won't be converted into PDFs as they would using Adobe Acrobat's Combine Files tool. To begin, select Menu on a PC or File on a Mac. Then select Create from the drop-down menu, followed by PDF Portfolio from the submenu. When the Create PDF Portfolio dialog box appears, select Add Files. From there, you can add nearly any file stored on your computer or connected storage. You can also add all the files in a folder, but note that this option doesn't add the folder itself, or add PDFs from your scanner, or the contents of your clipboard. You'll also notice an option to add a web page. I don't recommend using this option because it will convert the URL to a PDF, which often looks different than the original and can make your portfolio too large. Instead, we'll look at how to add a linked preview of the URL in just a moment. As you add files, keep in mind that Adobe recommends limiting PDF portfolios to fewer than 16 individual files totaling less than 50 megabytes. Larger portfolios may present performance issues. Today I'm going to add files from my computer. After locating and selecting each file, select the Open button on a PC or Add Files button on a Mac. Once added, you can drag them to the order you want them to appear in the portfolio. Finally, select the Create button. A tab with the label Portfolio 1 will appear. You can rename the portfolio as you would a regular PDF by selecting Menu and Save on a PC, or File and Save on a Mac, and then following your normal saving process. All the files will appear in the portfolio window. Press the up or down arrows on your keyboard to view the files sequentially, or view specific files by selecting them in the portfolio window. PC users will see a preview button when viewing non-PDF files. At the time of this recording, this button is not working. However, you must still select it in order to move to the next step, which is to select Open to launch the file's native application, such as Microsoft Word or Excel. A dialog box will appear asking if you're sure you want to open the file. Select the OK button if you are sure. The file should open in its native application, which in this case is Microsoft Word. After creating your PDF portfolio, use the buttons in the toolbar to add additional files, create a folder to organize the files, extract files, delete files, or open the files. You can also reorder the files by dragging them up or down in the portfolio window. Now we're going to look at how to add a linked preview to web content rather than converting the web content to a PDF within your portfolio. To begin, right-click on a PC or control-click on a Mac inside the portfolio window, and then select Add Web Content from the shortcut menu. When the Add Web Content dialog box appears, enter a file name, optional description, and the URL or embedded video tag. Then select the OK button. The linked preview will be added to your portfolio window, and you can open it by selecting it and then selecting Open File in the toolbar. And once again, a dialog box may appear asking if you're sure you want to open the file. Select the OK button if you are sure. And just like a regular PDF, remember to save your portfolio file to save your changes. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlist, How to Use Adobe Acrobat, where you'll find many related tutorials, including how to split PDFs in Adobe Acrobat using the updated interface. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.